Hello, I'm Professor Von Schmohawk, and welcome to Why You. So far, we have seen how substitution and elimination can be used to find a solution for a system of three linear equations in three variables. But how do we know that this solution is unique? Perhaps these three planes intersect in such a way that there are an infinite number of solutions, and this solution was only one of them. In this lecture, we will show how to recognize whether a system of equations has one solution, no solutions, or an infinite number of solutions by the type of results we get when solving the system. We will start by solving a system composed of three planes which intersect at a single point. We will then change one of the planes so that all three planes intersect along a line and see how the results differ. Finally, we will reorient the plane again to create a system with no solutions and see what happens when we try to solve the system. We will start with a system of three equations whose graph is composed of three planes intersecting at a single point. We saw in the previous lecture that systems like this can be solved using the same basic techniques we use to solve systems of two equations in two variables. We start by choosing two of the three equations and eliminate a variable, giving us an equation in two variables. For example, in this system, let's eliminate the variable z using the first two equations. Multiplying the first equation by 2, and adding the equations, gives us 15x minus 15y equals 0, or dividing both sides of the equation by 15, we get x minus y equals 0. We then repeat this process with a different pair of equations, giving us a second equation in the same two variables. This time, we'll use the first and third equations and once again eliminate z. Multiplying the first equation by 3, and adding the equations, gives us 19x minus 8y equals 0. We now have a system of two equations and two variables which can be solved to find the values of x and y. Once again, we will use the elimination method and multiply the top equation by negative 8 in order to eliminate the y terms. Now, when we add the equations, we get 11x equals 0, or dividing both sides by 11, x equals 0. Now that we know the value of x, we can set x to 0 in either of the two equations we just added and solve for y. Setting x to 0 in the first equation gives us 8y equals 0, or dividing both sides by 8, y equals 0. Knowing the values of x and y, we can now set the values of x and y to 0 in any of the three original equations and find the value of z. Setting x and y to 0 in the first equation causes the first two terms to vanish, giving us negative z equals 3, or z equals negative 3. So the x, y, and z values, which are the solution to our system of equations, are 0, 0, and negative 3. Since each variable was forced to a single value, we know that the solution is unique. This solution can be written as the ordered triple 0, 0, negative 3. These are the coordinates of the intersection of the three planes corresponding to this system of equations. And this point graphically represents the single unique solution of the system. But what will happen if the system we are solving has an infinite number of solutions? To find out, let's modify the third equation so that its plane is reoriented, causing the intersection of the three planes to form a line. The infinite number of points on this line correspond to the infinite number of solutions of this system. So let's see what happens when we solve this system of equations. Since the first and second equations are the same as the last example, using these equations to eliminate z produces the same equation in x and y as before. Now using the first and third equations to produce another equation in x and y, we multiply the second equation by negative 1 before adding to eliminate the z term. Adding the equations, we get 4x minus 4y equals 0, or dividing by 4, x minus y equals 0. We can then try to solve the system of two equations in two variables to find the values of x and y. But when we multiply the second equation by negative 1 and add the equations, both the x and y terms are eliminated, resulting in the equation 0 equals 0. As a general rule, if we start with a consistent system of three linear equations and three variables, and by eliminating variables we obtain an equality between two equal numbers, then this indicates that the system has an infinite number of solutions. You may recall from previous chapters that obtaining an equality between two equal numbers in systems of two linear equations and two variables also indicates an infinite number of solutions. So what if the system we are trying to solve is inconsistent, having no solutions? To create a system with no solutions, let's modify the third equation so its plane is oriented in a way that creates no points common to all three planes. Now let's see what happens when we try to solve this system of equations. Since the first and second equations are the same as in the last two examples, using these equations to eliminate z produces the same equation in x and y as before. Now using the first and third equations to produce another equation in x and y, we multiply the first equation by negative 1 before adding so that we can eliminate z. Now, adding the equations, we get negative 4x plus 4y equals negative 4, or dividing both sides by 4, negative x plus y equals negative 1. We can then try to solve this system of two equations and two variables to find the values of x and y. But when we add these equations, both x and y are eliminated, resulting in the equation 0 equals negative 1. If we start with a system of three linear equations in three variables, and by eliminating variables, we obtain an equality between two unequal numbers, such as 0 equals negative 1, then this indicates that the system has no solutions. As you may recall, obtaining an equality between two unequal numbers also indicates the same thing in a system of two linear equations in two variables. And we saw earlier that obtaining an equality between two equal numbers indicates an infinite number of solutions. However, in systems of three linear equations in three variables, it is possible to obtain both results. In other words, we can obtain an equality between two unequal numbers and an equality between two equal numbers in the same system. This can happen when two of the equations describe parallel planes, and the third equation describes a plane which is identical to one of the other planes. During the process of eliminating variables, the pair of equations which describe the parallel planes will produce an equality between two unequal numbers, indicating no solutions. And the pair of equations describing identical planes will produce an equality between two equal numbers, indicating infinitely many solutions. However, an indication of no solutions always trumps an indication of infinitely many solutions, since there can be no solutions for any system which contains parallel planes. Therefore, any time we get an equality between two unequal numbers, we know the system has no solutions. In the next lecture, we will see how to describe solution sets which contain infinitely many solutions.